Greetings, this is Ken Drews from the National Weather Service in Tucson. Let's take a look at rainfall totals for the monsoon so far and what's in store for the rest of the season. This presentation only takes into account rainfall that has occurred through August 7th. Remember, the official start of the monsoon was June 15th and the end will be September 30th. This is a total of 108 days. Day 54 of the monsoon is August 7th, so let's take a look at how we're doing for rainfall in southeast Arizona near the midpoint of monsoon 2019. Shown on the left is rainfall that occurred during June. There were isolated amounts over a half inch in the Santa Rita Mountains and the White Mountains, but most locations couldn't even muster a quarter inch of rain. While June is not normally all that wet, some of the higher terrain would normally see about an inch of rain during the month. An overall dry trend continued through July. Some areas near the international border and the Mogollon Rim received 2 to 4 inches of rainfall, as shown in yellow and orange on the left, and some mountain locales tallied 4 to 6 inches. Meanwhile, many areas from Tucson westward and near the New Mexico state line received less than an inch of rain. The map on the right indicates that only a few locations like Ajo, Bisbee, and northern Greenlee County were actually above normal for July, with a large part of southeast Arizona coming up 1 to 3 inches short, as shown in the yellow and orange colors on the map on the right. Through August 7th, most areas received between a half inch and 1.5 inches of rain, which is a little closer to normal for the first week of August in southeast Arizona. Taking a look at the first half of the monsoon all at once, the green and yellow areas on the left map show where the most rain fell. The map on the right shows that most areas were drier than normal thus far. The areas shown in brown have only received between 30 and 80% of the average rainfall for the monsoon normally received through August 7th. Let's take a look back at the Climate Prediction Center's precipitation forecast made back in May. The outlook for June through August, on the left, projected below normal rainfall for southeast Arizona, while the outlook for July through September indicated equal chances of above, below, or near normal rainfall. These outlooks, which took into account several factors, are what led to predictions of a delayed onset of monsoonal moisture and precipitation. Looking at a few places where we have up-to-date monsoon rainfall totals through August 8th, with the exception of Ajo, you can see that rainfall at most locations are indeed below where they should be. Looking forward, the weak El Nino conditions that were in place have ended, meaning that the water temperatures in the equatorial Pacific are no longer warmer than normal, but are close to average, and are expected to remain that way into this fall. Thus, the chances for increased tropical cyclone activity funneling tropical moisture into southeast Arizona during the latter half of the monsoon are lower than previously expected. Looking at this map of computer climate simulations for September, we really don't see a discernible trend toward wet or dry during the month. Most of the indicators are showing yellow, white, or light green colors indicating near normal precipitation. The official outlook from the Climate Prediction Center for August through October continues to indicate warmer than normal temperatures across southeast Arizona. Precipitation has a slightly higher likelihood of being above average during August, but for August through October, there's an equal chance of receiving below average, above average, or near normal precipitation. So for those who would like to see more rain in their gauge, the remainder of August may be the best time to make up for the lack of rainfall so far this monsoon. Thanks for listening to this presentation. For additional information about the monsoon, climate prediction, and monsoon safety, see the websites listed here. Stay tuned for more information and stay safe.